Steve Easterbrook is a fourth generation chicken farmer.
All of our livestock is cage free. We're fed all organic feed.
While he doesn't have a mega mansion on his land, his dream was to one day build a large one-story rancher.
I want the flexibility, number one.
But after last night's marathon public hearing, his dream is a no-go. Richmond City Council voted to limit the size of homes built on ALR land to 4,300 square feet. Many speakers at last night's meeting said they needed this space to house their extended family.
We have not been heard. We've been disrespected. We haven't been consulted with. And we're very, very disappointed.
The issue of mega mansions has long torn the community apart. It came to light 2 years ago when locals raised concerns about speculation and valuable farmland being kept out of reach for farming.
You don't want speculation on farmland. It's a land bank that's needed for future food production, and it's not supposed to be used for residential development.
The limits for homes on ALR land in Richmond have continued to shrink over the years. First, the city set a limit of 10,700 square feet. That was in 2017. But the motion put forward last night brings the figure to 4,300 square feet, a huge victory for those advocating against the mega homes.
In Richmond, especially being so close to all the residential development and the speculative real estate and the money laundering, and we know that a lot of this is happening on our farmland, and it's really destroying the farming community.
While Easterbrook agrees that there is a problem when it comes to these mega homes and criminal activity, he says the decision actually hurts farmers like him.
We don't want our equity to be impaired against our residential neighbors' equity, because at some point, we may want to retire.
But after years of talk, critics say at least a decision has been made and the community can focus on moving on. Tina Lovegreen, CBC News, Richmond.